So this is what it's like at the Grand Ole Opry.
Yeah. Yeah. Woo!
I misread the sign on the way. I thought we were going to Nashville, Tennessee. Had a whole different set plan. Yeah. They told me, you know, it's the famous Nashville. It's not that old. I don't know how it's taken us so long to get here. But we are really glad to be here and with our pal Mick Lowe opening up and the great welcome. Yeah. That's our special guest on guitar, Charlie Sexton from Fowler, is playing the double bass and upright bass.
Yeah.
On the keyboards, that's Steve Naive, of course.
Yeah.
And on the drums, the one and only Mr. Pete Thomas.
Yeah.
So we've been traveling around the country, we've been all sorts of places, and you know, with probably in mind of all the things I learned. I never went to university or nothing, I didn't even go to sort of proper school after a while. So I learned everything I know from records and books, and most of those from the United States, so it gives you a pretty sort of funny idea, everything coming off a 45 record or a 33 record when I could afford those, yeah. And motion pictures. So you got all kinds of crazy ideas. And one day I was in my favorite record shop in Liverpool when I was about 17. And I was going through the new releases and I had a Pink Floyd record. And I went to pick it up and the guy behind the desk went, he got the idea of the kind of music I like. He said, put that down, son. You'll do yourself a mischief. So I said, well, what about this here record? I've never heard of this fella. I said, it's unusual because he's Dutch. Yeah. Bruce Springsteen. He's not Dutch? Because I didn't know then. Nobody in England had heard him, just me. This was 1973. It was Bruce's first record. I took it home. And it's full of incredibly romantic songs. And as time went on, I became a big fan. And all his songs were about girls in red dresses and a car racing by. And Roy Orbison was playing on the radio. He made it sound like the most magical place in the world. He wrote about the boardwalk and the tilt-a-world, whatever the fuck that is. So when I went to the seaside, near where my grandmother lived in Birkenhead, they just had one sad donkey tied to a post. In case the fucker ran away. Anything to stop us having fun, you know. And there I go, and I started writing these songs, and I said, one day I'll get as good as Bruce, and I'll be able to go to Nashville, Indiana, and I'll be impressed. So much with my grasp of the American idiom. And then we came to the United States in 1977, and one of the last gigs we played before they threw us out of the country and chased us off television and said you'd never work again was in Asbury Park, New Jersey, where Bruce came from. And I got to look around, and you know the conclusion I came to? I walked down the boardwalk and I thought, that Bruce Springsteen, he's a genius. He's made this sound like the most fantastic place in the world. And you know what I found at the end of the boardwalk? You know what I found? A telescope. And you could put 25 cents in it, and sometimes you'd see the sea. And you know what else they had? They had a sad donkey tied to a post. So I threw the words away of that song and wrote this one instead. I was Johnny the Green.